finally, the topic that I just wanted to throw out there for you folks is Mike Elgin, who writes for Computerworld, had a column a couple of weeks ago that I thought was fascinating, where he talked about how we interact with computers and how we still use keyboards. QWERTY, Q-W-E-R-T-Y, QWERTY-style keyboards, which were designed in the 1860s to deal with problems of manual typewriters and how the keys worked, okay? And so Elgin's point is that we are still using this technology at a time when you've got AR and VR and HoloLens and Google Glass and all kinds, I mean, multi-touch on an iPad or the phone, lots of ways of interacting, and yet we still tend to gravitate toward QWERTY-style keyboards. And so his feeling is that over the next couple of years, as technology advances and we are able to actually access information with other devices or with multi-touch, that people would eventually realize that that's not productive, that you can do more with gestures and touch than you can typing things in.
And voice.
In fact, yeah, good point. Because, you know, one of the things that's happening now with the rollout of Siri and Alexa and all of these, Cortana, is that people are getting used to using their voice to navigate or get information. And that the whole idea of sitting down in front of a computer and typing something in is going to change. So I thought it was interesting. I'm not sure. I think Mike is sort of a futurist, and he sees this coming faster than I think it's coming. I think it's not going to be a couple of years from now that companies will suddenly say, here's your HoloLens, and we're taking away your keyboard. I think that's a recipe for disruption that might eventually be good and productive, but in the short term isn't going to happen. So, but I just wanted to throw this out there. So my question with that setup is, do you think that makes sense? Do you think he's on the right track, or do you think that that's just sort of pie in the sky, technology will save us someday?
Well, I mean, I think we have changed pretty remarkably over the last 10 years. Multi-touch, 2007, that's 10 years ago. It didn't exist on a consumer level, only in real high-end, fantastical prototypes.
And actually, Mike makes the point that it was Apple's decision to take away the keyboard and force users to use multi-touch and the keyboard that would come up on the screen that actually forced that. That you
Absolutely.
Have to force this to happen, or people will never get away from it.
I mean, if you look at all the smartphones before that, they were Trios and Blackberries. And they all had hardware keyboards. And, people were typing like this, which is crazy. But that's what they liked and that's what they used. And Apple got a lot of flack for not having a hardware keyboard yet.
Balmer was talking, Steve Balmer said that never going to work because it doesn't have a keyboard. Forget it.
Right.
And all right. So anyway, your point was that we have already modified.
I think we have a lot. I think that the UI or the interface that we use to input information has changed dramatically. And as you say, we do use voice more, but there's a comfort level with a keyboard.
I like my keyboard, even my own screen keyboard.
You're talking to a journalist, though.
I think the comfort level is entirely generational, though. I mean, I work a lot with elementary schools in my area, and I'll tell you, during their computer classes, the kids sit there, touch their screen, and they're like, why isn't this a touch screen? Yep. They sit there and they complain, why can't I just talk to my computer? I talk to my Alexa at home, why can't I talk to my computer? So I think it's a generational thing. You know, all of us are from the era that we remember the IBM click-clacky keyboards. The current generation, even the ones in college, they don't remember that. For them, keyboards has always been slow. It slowed them down. So I think we are going to see it, but it's more of a generational shift. Until the ones in the power and the control of design right now, are willing to say, yes, I'm willing to give up a keyboard, I think the keyboards are going to stay.
I think that's a really good point. If the applications that I'm using don't require me to use a keyboard, then I'm not going to use a keyboard.
Right.
If it's all touch-enabled, then sure, I'll do that.
Yeah.
But most of the applications I use now.
Yeah, I can't remember the last time I used the tab key to navigate a screen, which I did 10 years ago all the time.
Right.
So yeah, totally. And speaking to the generation thing, I have a 5-year-old son, and he can't write yet, but he uses my iPad like a pro.
Yeah, I've seen lots of friends who have kids, and young kids, 2-3 years old, and they can navigate through that.
At 6 months, he knew how to unlock my phone just by naturally.
I think that's
doing
a different security question that we're going to have to talk to you about. Okay, good point, though. I mean, you're absolutely right. I hadn't thought about the generational thing. I actually remember the IBM Selectric. We won't go there. an ancient electric typewriter. But It does sound like this is coming or something is coming.
And I say, sure, give me more choices. Give me more options. Sure. But
don't mandate it.
Don't mandate
it. But the problem is if you don't mandate it, people will never get away from what they're comfortable with.
What's funny is that my favorite feature of the newest version of Google Assistant is that I can type to it.
Yeah. Well, they're doing type to Siri in I think, iOS 11.
So we went backwards. You know, we started with voice only, and now they're adding the keyboard. Because sometimes when it's just not... I don't want to talk to my phone in public. I don't.
I don't use Siri unless I'm in the car by myself. Home with Alexa and I want to hear some music or something. But wandering around in public, talking, just, I don't know. And maybe that's a generational thing, too. As you say, kids don't look at that as strange or different. And I do.
One thing I think
even at conferences now, the number of journalists I see who have a Surface tablet, and then only when they're going to be writing for a while, then you see them coming out with their keyboard attachment. But I know so many journalists, and I'm sure all of you have, who say, that's a conference. I just filed everything from my iPhone or from my iPad. So we are getting to that point where the keyboard is no longer as necessary as we used to think.
It'll be one tool of many that we use.
Exactly.
I do think that QWERTY is never going to go away, though. There's just too much muscle memory and education. It's not going to happen. Yeah. Okay. I can close my eyes and type. Might be faster, but it's going to take me time to learn it.
For certain use cases.
Yeah. It's just, I don't think that's going to, I think devices will always have some form of a keyboard. We might use it less, and it might be out of the way most of the time, but it'll be there if we want it.
All right. Well, the future will let us know. Yeah. Okay, any final thoughts about anything that we've talked about? Great.
I gotta go order my Azure stack. I'll be back.
Go get your Azure. I'm gonna go order a keyboard.
Gotta make sure my security policies are all set.
All right. Well, listen. I want to say thanks to Mike, Brandon, Fahmida. Thank you for being here again. I'm Ken Mingis. Now you know what we know.